Nelson Zatu, United Nation Population Fund. Amina Banga supporting my program, Safeguard Young People, SYP.
Is a community of interest national broadcaster that is committed to empowering the youth, women, and protecting the lives of children. YFM believes that when young people and women are empowered, they will be able to contribute to the nation's development at all levels. YFM works in partnership with a number of organizations in its quest to meet young people's and women's sexual, reproductive health and rights needs. One of the organizations is the United Nations Population Fund, UNFPA. With support from UNFPA, YFM is able to run a number of programs and awarenesses that aims at educating young people on issues of SRH&R and Comprehensive Sexuality Education, CSE. The programs include Youth Talk, Lover's Corner Special, and Kumasukilana, among others. With this support, YFM, through Lover's Corner producers, organized a variety show in Mangochi on Valentine's Day. Bearing in mind that on this day, a lot of young people plan to take their loved ones to different places to spend the day, others think that it is the right day for them to start having sex, of which most of the times is not safe, as they do not use condoms, but also are not aware of their HIV status. It is for this reason that the show was held, so that as young people are celebrating Valentine's Day, they should get information on SRH&R and CSE, which in turn will help them make informed decisions in their relationships about their sexual health. There were many activities that were conducted, of which young people were at the center of them all. The activities included music by young artists, which drew much of the youth attention. The songs had different messages from love to HIV and AIDS. Some of the young musicians were drawn from Zomba as cursed artists, who also attracted more youths and also spicing up the show, keeping it lively right till the end. The guest artists were given a chance to talk to their fellow youth and encourage them on the goodness of HIV testing and counseling and accessing sexual reproductive health services, condoms being one of it. Apart from music, the event also used dancing competitions, which was a very powerful too, as Mangochi Secondary School and Faith Secondary School competed for their position of good dancers. Through the dancing, young and talented youths showcased their talents and managed to get away with their T-shirt prizes as a motivation. This also helped to mobilize a lot of young people to come for the event as well as to take part. Not only were there dances and music, but also quiz sessions on issues concerning sexual reproductive health and rights. It was strongly observed that through this participatory method, youths were able to express the information they know about sexual reproductive health and rights. This also helped us to know how much knowledge young people have on SRH and R, and look at how the gaps that are there can be filled. Young people who responded well during the quiz time also won some T-shirts. The show was also spiced up by catwalk and modeling. The event was well prepared by the few secondary school students of Mangochi who participated in the event. Yoneko, through its radio station, publicized the event and mentioned that all youths who want to participate for the event should get prepared for the different activities, which proved positively during the event. HIV testing and counseling was also among the activities conducted on the day. The facilitators for the event were able to articulate more benefits when one get to know his or her status, and the youths were much interested to go and have their blood tested. During the HIV counseling and testing, 88 youths get their blood tested, of which 54 were male and 34 were female, their ages ranging from 10 to 29. Of all the people who got tested, 87 were found negative and 1 positive. The youths themselves confessed that they benefited a lot as they have learned on the goodness of using contraceptives, and at the same time, as a Valentine's Day, they could have been engaging themselves in immoral behaviors, but the event kept them engaged all day.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
In conclusion, the event went on well as it managed to reach out to over 3,000 youths, and it is expected that the messages disseminated will have an impact on the lives of young people from Mangochi district. A big hand for the secondary school matrons and padlons for making sure that the students returned to their respective schools in time. Yoneko commends UNFPA for the support that it gives for such events. YFM, the real voice of the youth, women and children.
Never, 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 never